My name is Scott Gyssler. I'm the coordinator for the CTI program for the air traffic control degree at Broward College. Being an air traffic controller is, to me, is an exciting. They say it's a stressful job, but it's a very rewarding because every day you're helping large numbers of people move from one place to another place safely and efficiently.
What instruments do you need to fly into the class proper?
You have to be IFR.
The CTI program that we have an agreement with the FAA is a two-year associate's degree. And by completing that program, the student is issued a letter of recommendation in which they attach to their application when they apply for a job and get preferred hiring. The first semester of the program covers about 70% of what the FAA requires for us to teach under the basics. So they learn about the FAA, the different airspaces. It talks about approaches and different handling, separation standards, weight turbulence, and a variety of other areas that interact with air traffic control. So after the first term, they go to the second semester, they would go into the tower simulator, which is where we teach them how a VFR tower operates and how to apply rules for separation standards for runway separation. The students are suggested of 30 hours a semester to be in the simulator. The student also goes into what we call the radar simulator. In that simulator, they're going to do terminal radar, which is the close airspace around the airport, and they're going to do the en route radar, which is the airspace between airports and at high altitudes. Once they meet the application requirements, then they're going to take what they call an ATSET test. Then you have security, medical, a psychological test. Part of the requirements to be hired is you have to be hired before you turn age 31. After approximately about 12 to 15 years of work, they're going to be making over between $130,000 to $160,000 a year.